गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? होपिंग ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस क्लास टिल सेक्शन बी, डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द फॉलोइंग। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी हैव डन, डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटीज एंड डिराइव्ड क्वांटिटी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन बीम बैलेंस एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बैलेंस। Let us see the difference between beam balance and electronic balance. We will make it two column like this, and then first here we will write down in beam balance. It is a very simple device commonly called taraju, whereas electronic balance, it is an electronic device. Second difference is beam balance is used by shopkeeper and vegetable sellers or vendors. Electronic balance is used for scientific purpose in laboratories and shop due to their high degree of accuracy. Third difference is when both the pans are empty or loaded with equal mass, then the beam is horizontal and the pointer points vertically up, whereas in electronic balance show zero reading when no object is placed on the balance. Now we'll see the third difference between clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Again, we have to make it a two column. First clinical thermometer, second laboratory thermometer. Now first difference is in clinical thermometer, it is used to measure temperature of human body, whereas in laboratory thermometer, it is used to measure temperature of object in laboratory. Second difference is it has a very narrow temperature range from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius, whereas in laboratory thermometer it can measure temperature ranging from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Third difference is it has a kink in clinical thermometer, it has a kink in the mercury column, whereas in laboratory thermometer it has no kink in the mercury column. Dear students, let us see the next topic, section D, answer in detail. Now we'll do answer in detail, question answer. First question of this section is write the step to be followed while measuring a length using ruler. So let us see the answer. Here question is written, write the step to be followed while measuring a length using ruler. Answer is, the following steps to be followed while measuring a length using ruler. First, place the ruler along the length to be measured parallel to its graduation. Second point is, make sure that the zero mark of the ruler coincide with one of the end of the length to be measured. Third point is, in some rulers the end may be broken and the zero marks may not be clearly visible. In such cases some other digit, say mark 1, can be taken as the initial reading. You must remember the digit taken and subtract it from the final reading at the other end to get an accurate measurement of the length. Fourth part is, the edge must be exactly vertical above the mark to be read, otherwise the reading will be wrong. These are the steps to be followed while measuring a length using ruler. Now let us see next question number 2. How can we calculate the area of a matchbox? Answer is by using formula length into breadth of each surface and then add the result. In this way we will get the area of matchbox. So how many surfaces are there in matchbox? You will find there are 6 surfaces. Like this matchbox is there, 1 2 3 4 5 6 6. So we have to use the formula of length into breadth for each surface. So length into breadth, their length and breadth are different in each surface. So we have to find out their length and breadth and multiply it and then add all the area of the surface. We will get it the answer. Now question number 3. Write a note on beam balance. It is a very simple device. Answer is, it is a very simple device commonly called taraju, which is used by shopkeeper and vegetable sellers to weigh the articles. It has a straight horizontal beam supported in the center on a pivot, two pans of equal mass having at equal distance from the center. The object is placed in one pan and standard weights are placed in the other pan till the beam becomes horizontal with the pointer at the center. In this way, we are using beam balance. So dear students, today this much only. We will see next in the next class. I will explain you fill in the blanks in the Zoom class. So today this much only. Thank you and take care.